welcome to Wisconsin Prep Hockey from Marathon Park. With Spencer Hart, I'm George Hirsch, and we're all set for a non-conference contest. The home finale for the Warriors coming in, number two in the state, with a record of 17-3-1 as they head to tournament play next week. And for the Crusaders of Madison Edgewood, the visitor here this afternoon, they are at 13-9-1. The Crusaders out of Madison Edgewood. They will be in the purple. Warriors in their home gold, the blue trim helmets. And Spencer, after the last game we did with Marshfield and West, let's hope this is a little more competitive.
Yeah, I mean, it was competitive for the first period against Marshfield, but after that it was a blowout for the entire game. So let's hope Madison keeps West on their toes and gives us a good game today.
Well, they need that before a tournament. You don't want to go into a tournament without having, had a little pressure along the way. In the net this afternoon for West is Ryan Groff, the sophomore. He wears number 29. Netminder for the Crusaders of Madison Edgewood is Ben Zagelski. He's the junior, wears number 35.
We're going to have a tripping penalty here early here, George.
Well, the Edgewood player in the box, penalty box, is Carter Huffman, a junior. And didn't take him long to find out when you're a visitor, you don't know what you can do yet necessarily, maybe. Maybe you can't get away with that here in central Wisconsin, like you can up in the capital city. But anyway, we are set to go on the faceoff. Just underway, just a few seconds in. And on the faceoff to the left of the Crusader goalie, the Warriors control. They have a power play right off the bat, and the Crusaders send it down the ice. Fred Richards, senior wing, sends it down for them. The Warriors go back to get it. And so far, they haven't cleared it out of their own defensive zone. Now they do. And skating with the puck, going all around behind, trying to set it up in front. Now they go back out and dump it back down in the corner. Christian Bartertson did a lot of skating with the puck that time. Now it comes out to Kenneth Therrelson. And out in front of the crease. Slot. Shot. Goes to the right. Back out they go again. The defenseman over on that side for West is Josh Boleen, one of their co-captains. Near side to Kenneth Therrelson. And they put it, pass in front between the circles, but it didn't connect. So now West with less than a minute left in the penalty. They put it across and it's cleared out by the Crusaders. Change in the line for West. Jacob Evans comes in for Kellen Therrelson at a defenseman position. Goes far side with the puck. Right now, Edgewood is challenging the Warriors, but they are able to get it in the neutral zone. They dump it back out, Sam Teckel. And it comes up neutral zone. Skating with it for West, Zach Pearson. Here's a shot on goal by number 6 of Madison Edgewood. But it's blocked by Roth. Over on the far side in front of the bench goes out of play. Out of play in front of the Crusaders bench. Line change now. Penalty killing unit, only second left, so they really don't have to pay any attention to that. Just on the faceoff here now. Still 5-on-4. Puck dropped to the ice, controlled by the Warriors. And full strength, puck behind the net. Back over near side, Crusaders skate out with it. Their defenseman, back skate, set up, far board. And back to retrieve for West, Hunter Rickliffs. Rickliffs sends it up to his teammate Christian Bartertson. Pass deflected, out in the between the red circles. but West unable to handle it. Now they go to the far side to Josh Boleen. Skating near side boards, Jacob Evans. Evans trying to set things up. Cross-rink pass out, but beautiful pass and a goal.
Wow.
Holy smokes, number 21, I believe, for West. That was a beautiful pass.
That was a great setup. Pass over to, like I said, number 21, Nick Teckel. That was fine puck work there.
Well, it was 1-2 and goal. And the Warriors score first here in this non-conference game from Marathon Park. The Valley season is over for West. They ended up in a tie with Spash, each with one loss, and that to each other. Here's another nice pass, and this time the goalie has it in the breadbasket. It rebounds out, and that transition, Edgewood sends it down. Bryce Turnis, there's number 4 for them. Another opportunity for West, Spencer, and that time the goalie was in position.
Yeah, they're actually going to give the goal to number 9, Kellen Tharaldson. Nick Teckel actually wasn't even a decision for that goal, assisted by number 4, Mark Sipple, number 12, Hunter Rickliffs.
Okay. That clarifies that. That was a beautiful setup, though. I mean, you talk about a beautiful pass. In the red circle, to the left of the net, to the outside of the circle, skating in full force, and just a slap shot on the faceoff now at center ice. We're inside 13 minutes left here, so we're 4 minutes in. West up 1-0. Kate Lemmer's in there now for West defensively. And
we got another penalty, I believe, on Madison.
Another whistle. Another Crusader in the box. This time, Carter Huttman. Hold it a minute. Wasn't it Carter in there before? I don't remember. No? Okay. Because I know I've mentioned his name already. On the power play now for the Warriors. In the left corner, Max Teckel sends it down. Now they come all the way around to the post on the far side. And a shot left of the net. Shot was taken by Nick Teckel. And a whistle. Well, the goalie for Edgewood, Ben Sigalski, he's been busy already. He's a 6 foot, 150 pound junior. Face off to his right, power play Warriors. Pass near side to Evans. Jacob Evans out in front, the goalie on the puck. Stoppage of play. Still a minute and a half left in the penalty on the Crusaders. I don't know the nicknames here, the Warriors and the Crusaders.
Couldn't have wrote a better story for today.
No, we'll go back to the Middle Ages on this one. On the far side, trying to get around the corner, and does, beautiful job. Back out to Max Teckel for the Warriors. That was number 7 over there, Max Zingler, who did a nice job of getting around, and now they set up the power play. And they come to the near side, back out to the slot to Jacob Evans. In the left circle, they dump it down again behind. You can see what the Warriors are trying to do. The Crusaders, to their credit, they are facing the skaters head on. They are in their face.
Yeah.
There's a shot.
Oh my gosh.
Whoa. Shot, rebound again.
Scores! Wow.
Holy cow.
They really deserve that one there, George. Woo. They worked hard for that one.
You know, I would have to say the goalie's having some problems. He's not holding the puck. He's letting it rebound and Boy, that's dangerous.
Yeah. Give Whoa. Credit to Kellen Therelson. He came rocketing on a rebound and eventually set up the winning score, or the score, but boy, he doubled to the ice on that one, and give the assist to him.
On the faceoff now, we're at full strength because of the goal for the Warriors. Crusaders in Warrior defensive zone around the horn to the far side. On the board, trying to get it to the near side over there for them is number 8, part of their first line, Jake Schmaltz. And the Warriors are right back at it again. Here's a shot just over the bar. Back to the board. Alex on, still controls. And the Warriors have it in the attacking zone. And a nice pass, a leave. Nobody there in between the circles, however. And a nice pass, and there's a breakaway out of the, shoulder save for Roth. West made a change on a breakaway. And boy, I'll tell you, they just came on time here to and make him look, at least know somebody was next to him.
Really shows the confidence that they have in Ryan Roth, too, as well, back in goal.
On the action on the ice now in the neutral zone, the Warriors. Christian Bartertzit sends it far side. And the Crusaders dump it down. A little dump and chase here, but the Warriors are there. Cross rink pass. Near side. Skating up the near side is number 23, Max Teckel. Over to the far side to Josh Boleyn. Pulling it off the board, Christian Bartertzit. Now the Crusaders will ice it here. They need a little breather. 9:32 left first period. Spencer, how about that second goal for West?
Second goal is going to be a power play goal going to number 6, Cade Lemmer, assisted by number 8, Alex Zahn. That's Lemmer, or Zahn to Lemmer for the power play goal.
Well, we've had a chance to watch now for about 7.5 minutes, and you know one thing I'm noticing? I think the West skaters are faster.
Yeah, a little bit.
A little faster. You know, the Crusaders are trying to stay in their face. Mm-hmm. They're trying to forecheck. They're trying to, you know, make and give up the puck. But the speed aspect is in West's favor here. As they penetrate, red circle. Oh, nice job defensively for the Crusaders. Getting that out of there for them was Hunter Straka.
You know, we've been together for a little over a week doing this here, and well, for me anyway. And I'll say, you know, a lot of West players are very good at stick checks. Getting that puck out of the possession of the opponent and really setting up a lot of the offense for West.
Well, a lot of that has to do with skating ability, balance, timing. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a real skill you work on, and they're a veteran unit, and you get better as you go along. Here's a slap shot from the near post, goes right of the net over to the far side. Backhand cross to the near side now. Crusaders, far side board, and you're talking about a forecheck. There's a nice one by Max Teckel, but it might be a penalty.
Yeah, they're going to get Max Teckel with
from my distance, it looked pretty good. But somebody closer thought otherwise. So that's going to be the first power play now coming up for the Crusaders of Madison Edgewood. This is a non-conference game. Wisconsin Valley Conference season is complete for Wausau West, at home at least. So let's see what the Crusaders do with a 5-on-4. They're first in the game. They set it up. And here's a shot. Comes off the pad of the goalie, Roth. Now set behind the board. Crusaders come back out in front again. Far side. And West will just clear it out. That job done by Brandon Thorson, part of the penalty killing unit. And here they dump it up again. And then they're going to make a couple of line changes. A couple of wings are coming in. Their defensemen stay put in this penalty killing unit.
Oof.
Check into the board, all the way around, and a goal.
What a response by
Edgewood. You know, there's a situation where the West player tried a check, up with the shoulder, and he didn't get him off balance. If he'd have gotten him off balance, it wouldn't have happened.
Yep.
But he was not successful. The skater kept his composure, kept his balance, and it was open. And it got past the goalie, Roth. Ryan Roth gives up his first goal. So a power play goal now for each team here in the first period. The Warriors on the run now. Shot off the glass behind the net. Now it comes to the near board. Here's another shot, a shoulder save. Shot taken by Josh Evans. The Warriors already here in this first period. They've used three lines on the ice. Puck in the corner, full strength after that goal. Hunter Rickless. Nick Teckel dogging number 12. Hunter Straka. Off the board pass. Still trying to get it out of their zone. There, now the icing call will take place, and you can tell us about the Crusader goal.
Crusader power play goal going to number 8. Jacob Schmaltz, assisted by number 26, Carter Hotman. That's Hotman to Schmaltz for the power play goal for the Crusaders.
And it's a 2-1 game. Warriors on top here at Marathon Park. On the faceoff. Both teams at full strength. Inside 7 minutes left, first period. Crusaders dump it down. Down in the corner to retrieve. Jacob Moore, 6'1 senior. Back to retrieve for West. Sam Sippel is number 26. He's the junior. Here's a shot, comes off the leg of the defenseman. Shot taken by Cade Lemmer. West keeps it in.
Oh,
right off the left side of the net that time.
Max Zingler had a wide open goal on that rebound.
Here's a rebound, here's a shot. Oh, beautiful save. Probably by accident as much as anything. The goalie, had just it was he was there, that's all. Yep. Up into the stands here. Didn't hit anybody. A couple of boys have the puck here. They're arguing about who's going to throw it in. Typical boys.
I don't know if they're going to throw it in there, George.
Oh, they're walking off. Okay. All right. Face off. Controlled by the Crusaders. They've had a couple. Here's a nice pass to himself along the far board. Nice job by Carter Hotman. He's had a couple of mentions tonight, one for a penalty. And right now, it's going to be it's going to be icing on the Crusaders. They'll come back to our right. Or it should be on West, I'm sorry. Because the faceoff is going to be to the left of the goalie, Brian Roth, the sophomore goaltender for West in this non-conference encounter. And his team is up 2-1, inside 5:30 left first period. Nice crowd here from, actually from Madison Edgewood too.
Yeah, they
and
made
of
the
course
trip
there's a, another game going on in the other, in rink number 2, the Storm is involved in a contest at the same time basically. Another icing call. Coming out for West is Hunter Rickless. Face off. Face off for West was Nick Teckel. And they're trying to get it out from their own zone. Crosswind pass, far side in front of the Crusader bench. Pulled back out of there, along the board. Here, West is setting it up. There's the shot, and a glove save for the goalie. Slap shot.
He saw that one all the way.
Yeah, number 9, Kellen Therrelson, the senior defenseman. West has 10 seniors on their team. Well, here we go. Like a lot of games this year, Edgewood has four seniors compared to 10 for West. West has three solid lines, a lot of depth. And because of their quality of play this year, they've given a lot of underclassmen plenty of time on the ice. So that's when you have a good program, Spencer, when you can do that.
Yeah.
Goes from year to, they don't reload, they reload each year. Right now they're number two in the state with that record. 17-3-1. Along the board, right down in front of the Crusader fans and some West folks who decide to sit down over there too. The West folks, student section to our right from the bleachers. And the Crusaders jumping in. Here comes a line change, and that was part of the strategy for them, is to get a couple of new defensemen out there. And immediately they get into action, but the puck is taken away. Max Teckel out in front of the crease, and the defenseman was there for the Crusaders to get rid of it. Now it goes back down, dumped back down by Sam Teckel. Around the back and coming back to the near side. The Crusaders doing a nice job right now of fronting the puck. Pass to the middle. And losing it to the Warriors. Pass far side, pulled down, and off the right side of the post. Puck comes to the far side, picked up by the Warriors. Skating with it, Alex Zahn, shot. Another rebound from the goalie. I don't know if he's taught to do that or just doesn't have the glove sense or what, but that is so dangerous. West, defenseman, over on the far side, Kellen Tharaldson. Shot from the post.
Yeah, I think we're gonna have a boarding call here.
Skating with it for the Crusaders behind the Warrior net, Jacob Moore, I should say the Edgewood net. Now we get the whistle on the change of possession. 2:19 left in this first period. It's gone by quickly, and Spencer has been competitive.
It has, you know, Madison Edgewood has come out lately and over the last 5-7 minutes or so and really just stuck it to West and kept it in the offensive zone.
Well, we'll have the face-off now on the penalty. So Zahn, Alex Zahn, 2-minute penalty for West. The Crusaders, who scored their goal midway through this first period on a penalty or a power play, they have another power play now for most of the last first couple minutes of this period. So let's see what they do with it. Trailing 2-1. West with the interception and offside. Yep, that was close. You could tell that Nick Teckel was aware of where he was. Problem was, behind him there was a teammate he didn't see.
Yeah, Josh Boleen kind of misread Nick Teckel's. He thought he was going into the zone and went right in.
So the offside call, face off, neutral zone. Controlled by the Crusaders. They have a power play, 5-on-4. They go to the near side. Battle for the puck. Pulled back out of there by Jacob Evans. Goes to the far side now. And all the way around the board to the near side, trying to set up their power play. West fronting along the boards. A little bit of a frozen puck along the boards, but play continues. Not that we can see it from here, but we know it's there somewhere. Coming out of there with it. The Crusaders. Back. Oh, nice job, and there's a burn. Oh, okay, the goalie now. Oh no! He almost whiffed. He had a lot of times for his sake, because otherwise that would have been a disaster. Okay.
Giveaway.
West. Still, now they intercept the puck. Nick Teckel. And West dumps it down on the penalty killing. It's a chance to run off some clock here as we're getting down to the last 30 seconds of this first period, and the penalty is over. So we are now at full strike. Crusaders off the glass, behind the net, down to our right, into the boards. Oh, here's a one-on-one with 5 seconds left in the period. The shot off the glove, off the glass, behind the net with 6/10 of a second left, face-off. That could have been big.
Yeah, and on the other end, Ryan Roth is, I think, in my opinion, he's pretty lucky he didn't get called for a tripping. I didn't see who was coming in streaking for the Crusaders, but he went down, and looked like Ryan Roth took out a skate from under him. So it was an exciting first period here, George.
It's been great. On the face-up, that's it. We played one. Spencer, how about the scoring in this first period?
So far, score for West going to number 9. Kellen Tharleson, assisted by number 4, Mark Sippel at number 12. Hunter Rickliff's the second goal for West. Power play goal going to number 6, Cade Lemmer, assisted by number 8, Alex Zahn. Only goal for Madison coming on the power play goal going to number 8, Jake Schmaltz, and then assisted by number 26, Carter Hotman. Official shots on goal, well, being loaded right now, actually. 18 shots on goal for West, and 6 shots on goal for Madison. Again, those are unofficial, but shots on goal don't really showcase. You know, this is a pretty close game here, George.
Well, this game you are watching is a rebroadcast on Wausau Access, or Wausau Area Access Media, and Charter Cable Channel 981. To view any previously recorded games, you can also go to WAAM's website at waam.bybit.com. waam.bybit.com. Second period follows. We are set for period number 2 as the competing teams come out of their locker room between periods 1 and 2, and Wausau West leading it 2-1. And of course they'll switch nets. The Madison Edgewood Crusader goalie, Ben Zagalski, is to our right. To our left, as we take a look at it, Ben Roth, the sophomore for Wausau West. And both teams at full strength, starting period number 2 from Marathon Park. Non-conference prep hockey. Awaiting the okay from the linesman. And he doesn't get it. So they're going to talk of, I don't know if it's an ice issue or what.
They're going to skate around here.
Okay.
Interesting. Not quite sure what this is about.
Well, the goalies in the meantime are doing their stretch. They're hoping that's as much as they have to do for a while. But maybe it's a matter of some water on the ice that has to reach a certain point. Not sure. Anyway, West scored 2 goals. Crusaders of Madison Edgewood countered with 1. Crusaders come into this one with 13 wins, 9 losses, and a tie. West 17-3-1, and now we're off and skating. Not going to say running. We're off and running. We're off and skating. And on the face-off, the Crusaders in their defensive zone, trying to clear it out of there behind their own goalie, and it's right out in front. And this time the goalie puts the paw on it, and we'll have to give him a save.
It's pretty dangerous pass right in front of the goal.
That's one of the nice things that makes hockey such a great thing to watch, Spencer, is the speed and how fast things can happen. You know, almost faster than the eye can keep up with at times. Well, they're waiting again because of
discussing something.
Some issue. Well, the players know that they're not going to be skating for a little bit, so they're just going to skate around, keep loose. We've 16 seconds in this second period, and we already have a delay. Now, I don't know if that means somebody's going to come out and do some maneuvering with the ice, or if they're just waiting for it to freeze up a little more. As you look across the way, we get started again. And right off the faceoff, the Crusaders on the attack. Skating is Carter Hotman, a name that's mentioned quite a bit here for them. West, up to the neutral zone. And that's where it's held up. Back skating for the Warriors. Jacob Evans, near side, off the near board. Talon Therrelson, number 12 is Hunter Reckliffs. He's dogging the skater for the Crusaders in the Warrior attacking zone. And the Warriors now make a full line change. All five skaters. So we'll try to pick them up as we go along here. As their second unit is on the ice. And that includes Christian Bardardson, Nick Teckel, defenseman Max Teckel. And it's Josh Boleyn handling the puck right now, and he goes back to defense position here. On the other side is Sam Sipple, the junior, number 26. He's awaiting the puck, gets it, slips it back in, but it's intercepted. But the Warriors get it back again, and Josh Boleyn in the corner, checked into the boards, sends it around to the other side, picked up there by Fred Richards. Richards, a two-on-one, a shot. The left in the net. Richards lost his balance just when he wanted to really let loose. Now here's off a stick, defensive stick of Sam Sipple. And the Warriors, they want to send it down, but it's intercepted, center ice. And keeping it in the offensive zone, number 13, Fred Richards. For the Crusaders. West trying to clear it out again. They get back to the neutral, the back skating near side. Dumping it in, dump and run for the Crusaders. Number 27, Jack Royer. It seems to me right now that the Crusaders have their first line out there. The Warriors have their second line. And also that the Crusaders have made some adjustments here between periods. They've had more ownership of the puck here early in the second period than they did in the first. Pretty much throughout the whole 17 minutes. Puck on the far side. Right in front of the Warrior bench. Stick handle near side. Again. Whoop. Gets away, it took an odd bounce on Kellen Therrelson. He went back to get it, however. Now, here we have a wave off of any kind of icing, so in play to the left of the goalie. Warriors on the attack. Puck out of the far board. Max Singler, number 7. And back over to retrieve for West, Alex John. The goalie watches it go around behind him. Crusaders on the attack again on front. Here's a shot and a goal.
Wow.
Number 24, I believe. Well, 20-something. 26.
Well, and Wausau West left that puck in the defensive zone Pass come over here on the near side, and there was nobody there to pick it up, and that set up the goal for the Crusaders.
It went off of a defender, just the hip, just enough so that Brian Roth lost, you know, the path of the puck. Now we're tied at two. Madison Edgewood now tied with Wausau West at two goals apiece. This is a non-conference game. Here's another opportunity. Roth fires it outside the net and the crease. What I'm seeing, Spencer, is that Edgewood changed up their strategy between the two periods. They're much more aggressive. They're depending on their defense more.
Yeah, in the manager and the coach for the team must have really let them know that it's a close game. If you guys get a little more aggressive, that, you know, tie game, and it's off to the races now.
There's a two-on-two in front. Oh, up high off the back glass. Shot taken by Kellen Theraldson for West. Now the Warriors come out, and this one's off the pads of the goalie. Comes all the way back to the defensive zone for West, where Nick Teckel picks it up. Skates around his goalie teammate. Gets up to the near board to Kellen Theraldson. Now it's dumped back down again. And a check in the boards, but Theraldson's able to handle it. All by himself. Beautiful job of skating in front. And the goalie sees the puck in the crease.
That was some nice skating by Nick Teckel. Really took it from coast to coast, giving the goalie for the Spartans, for the Crusaders something to think about.
Well, we've got another faceoff here. And a slap shot off the stick of the goalie. That was taken by Max Teckel. And his defense position on the near side. Puck now around behind the net, now along the board. Just below the scoreboard. And the Crusaders, nice pass. Off a stick, up and out of play off the net. Well, any thought West had when they were up 2-0 that they were going to be able to relax at all here this afternoon, that's gone by the board now.
Oh, yes.
They know they're in a contest. And Edgewood coming out of the Madison area with a 13-9-1 record. They've won some games. And now we've got a penalty.
On Madison for cross-checking.
It's going to be on number four, Bryce Turner. So the seniors in the box, power play West. Each team has a power play goal and a 5-on-5 goal in this 2-2 tie. 11:17 left here in period number two. And they power play for West. They set it up quickly. There's a pass. Oh, it gets right through. Pass far side, Josh Boleyn over to Kenneth Theraldson. Now this is Christian Bartertson with it out in front. Now they come. Pass in the crease. Goes right through. Again, West is trying to set it up between the red circles in the crease area. And they just continue now to set up the power play. They've got time. They've got a minute 18 left. They slap it down off the boards. So far, they've been in control in this power play. And now, on a transition, here's a shot and a rebound and a whistle.
We're going to have a penalty.
Whoa.
Interference.
That transition for the Crusaders couldn't have worked better for them. They got a wow.
We're gonna get Cade Lemmer here for interference. Yep.
Yeah, that's right. Now it's 4-on-4. That'll open things up. 4-on-4. 1 minute left in one penalty, 2 minutes left in the other. And an icing call. It's 4-on-4 now, so you go back to 5-on-5 rules. Faceoff will be to the left of sophomore goalie Ryan Roth. 5'10", 165-pound sophomore for the Warriors. And they control it, up ahead, snap back in. A little dump and run. Goalie Roth leaves it for a teammate. Over to the far side. Sam Teckel. And again, doing the same thing, skating with a puck, Nick Teckel. Showing some speed, skating, out in front. Rebound comes all the way back to the far board, where it's sent in by the Crusaders, waved off on the offside, or icing. Crusaders back skating, cross wing pass near side, the other defenseman to the wing. On the attack, there's a shot. Oh, came off a defenseman. Shot was taken by Carter Hotman. So now, it's a power play for the Crusaders. There's a check. Crusaders like that one. Little hip check there, down went the Warrior. Clean job. They have the power play now with a 2-2 game and a whistle.
Penalty.
And a penalty coming. And let's see. They haven't posted yet. Now they do. Oh. So now we go back to 4-on-4.
Check that, George. I think we might have coincidentals. Yep.
Okay. Oh, we do. We do. So now.
And a goalie change. Shane Ryan come in the game.
Yeah. Jake Severance. Jacob Warnke is in the net for West, number 30. So it's a power play here for 20 seconds for Edgewood. Warnke comes in, the senior, more experienced, to at least take care of this power play as the goalie directs traffic a little bit for his defenseman, trying to let him know what's... Here's a shot. Stick save, rebound, backs out, and now full strength. So the Warriors were able to handle it. A couple of anxious moments there, but they were able to handle the power play, penalty killing unit. So we're at full strength right now with a coincidental in the box, and the game tied at 2. Warriors. Again skating, Sam Teckel. No, that's number 12. Hunter Rickliff sends it behind the net. And skating out of there with it for the Crusaders is Cade McCaution. McCaution dumps it in. And they go far side, and McCaution to his knee, teammate on the board. Now they go to the far side. Puck, they keep it in play. And coming out, skating with it for West, Josh Boleen. Boleen looking for a teammate, a shot, goes left of the, or to the right of the net. He had a lot of smoke on it, but off target. Puck comes to the far side. Another shot, a pad save. Shot by Max Zingler. And a whistle for an off icing. Well, the Crusaders needed a break. Warnke stays in there for West. He's gonna conference a little bit with Max Steckel as they set up to the left of the Crusader goalie. And a goal off the faceoff. A goal off the faceoff. So the Warriors take the lead back. They've never trailed. It's been like 1-0, 1-1, 2-1, 2-2, 3-2 now. 7 minutes exactly left in the second period. Okay, face-off center ice, Warriors the lead back. This team has scored a goal here in this second period. Cade Lemmer gets the goal. Spencer will have the details for you when we get a break in action. Lemmer still in there now, skating with it, cross-wing pass, near side of Sam Teckel, and another whistle. Okay, Spencer, where do we have for the scoring?
Well, we're going to give the goal to number six, Cade Lemmer. I'm going to have to double-check the scores there during the second intermission because he announced that it was assisted by number six, Cade Lemmer. So that's not correct.
No.
So we'll have to get with him during the second intermission to get the official scoring on that goal. Again, that goal going to Cade Lemmer.
Okay. On the faceoff, the Crusaders dump it down the inside, back to retrieve for West. Frank DeVorney now as they have their third line in there. DeVorney, the sophomore. Up ahead, off the board to Alex Zahn. Near side intercepted by Bryce Kessel of the Crusaders. And they send it down. Back to retrieve. Showing a lot of speed with the puck. Number 18, Brandon Thorson. There's an attempt on the net. Another save for their goalie, Ben Zagelski. This is a 3-2 game, but again in that first, there's another goal. Wow. That's what I mean about prep hockey. You have to keep your eye on the puck because you look up at the scoreboard like I did, and it happened. And it's 4-2. Wow. Well, Wausau West, number two in the state, been there one or two all year long, started out number one. There's a reason. They have depth and they have skills. There, Olson with the goal. So now you've got two to talk about, Spencer, when we get a break here. As we are at full strength, 5:24 left. Second period.
Oh man.
Off the shoulder. West, all of a sudden, it's like they have just taken over. The puck is dead. They've been on the attack here. There's a slap shot and another goal. Oh, my God.
Three goals
that
in 2 minutes.
Jacob Evans. Jacob Evans.
Wow. That is absolutely amazing, George.
Well, you know, it was tied at two with 13:06 left. That means in 8 minutes, the Warriors have scored three goals.
Right.
And none of them are power play goals. And they've had a goal with their second unit, their third unit, a mix 2-3, and a mix 1-2. I mean, it's like, talk about thunder and lightning. On the ice right now, again, the Warriors retreating. Let's see, they've got Kellen Tharaldson. He has the puck on the near side, on the board. Up ahead to Sam Teckel. Teckel dumps it in. And now the Crusaders trying to get it up ahead. Flipping it right back is Kellen Tharaldson. All the way to the far board to Sam Teckel. Behind the net, on the attack, the Warriors have just all of a sudden, the game was tied at two, fairly early in the second period, and all of a sudden the Warriors, three goals in an 8 minute period, and they're just dominating. Glove save goes right past, down to the board. Crusaders trying to get it out of there. They have to wonder what hit them because they were came out early the second period with some adjustments, especially where they handled the defense. And now That's gone awry. Back to retrieve for West, Sam Teckel, or Max Teckel. Max Teckel up ahead to Brandon Thorson. And he's gonna come out as number 19, Christian Bartertson keeps it in. Now we've got a whistle. Now, how about updating the second period scoring here?
So we've got a goal unassisted going to number 9, Kellen Thorson. Third goal of the second period for the Wausau West Warriors, going to number 21, Nick Teckel, assisted by number 10, Jacob Evans, and number 23, Max Teckel. All coming within, like you said, about 8 minutes of each other.
On the faceoff, the Crusaders get behind the goalie now, Josh Warnke, for West. You know, Josh could talk about this a little bit. He came out here when it was, 2-2? Power play finishing up. And look what he's done. I mean, he's given a 5-2 lead without doing anything.
Right.
He can brag about that a little bit. It was my presence as a goalie on the ice that did it.
Yeah, right.
But it's, you know, it's unreal how the West, and we've seen him do it before, just a flurry. And it's like it gets contagious out there for them. Now with 2:25 left, full strike, Crusaders, center ice, dump it back. Warnke watches it go by. Puck picked up by Frank DeVorney, the sophomore. Now he leaves to Josh Boleyn. Boleyn up the center ice to Max Engler. And behind the Crusader goalie, Sigalski. Warriors, here's a shot. Off Sigalski, comes near side board. Kellen Thorson. Back out. Warriors set it up on the board. Sam Teckel behind the goalie. Near side. Kellen Thorson. Slop shot. And number 17, Frank DeVorney. He had some mustard on that one. Now he gets it back again. Now it goes back around the horn. Back there behind the net, Cade Lemmer. Cade Lemmer is a freshman. And Crusaders, just right now they're trying to survive. As the Warriors are just keeping it in. Now they finally clear it out a little bit. The Warriors back to retrieve Frank DeVorney. Full line change for the Crusaders. They need that. Down inside a minute left here in the second period. Up ahead, Warriors. Oh, nice pass. It is, oh, defensively a nice job. Skating with it was Sam Teckel. And the defenseman for the Crusaders poke checked it away, and that was Quinn Fredno. He did a nice job for them. Because it was a one-on-one setup. Crusaders. Well, the Warriors dump it back in. Puck goes in the far corner, or near corner, we should say. 20 seconds left in the second period. And the Crusaders will ice it. So they'll have a face-off with about 13 seconds left. We started this period West up 2-1 after one. The Crusaders tied it about 4 minutes in, and then the Warriors, in an 8-minute period, scored 3 goals. Spencer Hart will have those details for you as soon as this period ends. And it's going to be a matter of seconds now. Puck behind the board. And a slap shot goes behind far side. Horn. That's it for period two. After a couple, Warriors 5. Crusaders 2. Spencer, how about the second period scoring?
Second period scoring started with number 6, Cade Lemmer, unassisted. Next goal going to number 9, that would be Kellen Thorson, unassisted with that one as well. Third goal for West going to number 21, Nick Teckel, assisted by number 10, Jacob Evans, and then number 23, Max Teckel. for the Madison Crusaders. Lone goal going to number 26, Carter Hotman, assisted by number 8, Jacob Schmaltz, and then number 6, unrostered here for us. So unofficial shots on goal, not listed as of yet. We'll get that at the start of the third period. But like you said, the second period started out strong for Madison, and then just a flurry of goals for the Wausau West Warriors to give us a 5-2 score.
After 5-2, as Spencer mentioned. We'll be back after this. We are back here at Marathon Park. This is a non-conference game, finishing up the regular season for Madison Edgewood, the visitor, and the host Wausau West Warriors. With Spencer Hart, I'm George Hirsch, and we're set for the final 17 with West on top 5-2. And you look at shots on goal, Spencer, and no surprise.
Yeah, 29 for West, 11 for Madison Edgewood. So it's clear that in the second period that West came out swinging.
Okay. Let's see who the Warriors have out here for this line to start this period. Well, looks like it'll be Alex Zahn, Kevin Therrelson, Hunter Rickliffs, Brandon Thorson, and Nick Tickle. And that's their first line.
Yep.
That's where they started. And in the net is
Warnke,
the senior. He didn't start. Brandon Roth started.
We have a goalie change here for the Madison Edgewood as well.
On the opening faceoff of period number 3, it's controlled by Edgewood in their attacking zone to our right. And just keep it in. Their first line is Jake Schmaltz, Drew Lenz, Hunter Straka, Jack Breuer, and Gabe Brown. They don't go as deep as West, though. That you just kind of watch. You know, very seldom do you have full line changes, all 5 skaters, usually after a lot of time on the ice. But now it's a 3-on-2. And a shot and a save from Warnke. He had to step outside the crease. Not saying that would have gone in, but he still got involved. Well, here's a perfect example of it. For Edgewood now, 3 of their 5 skaters are new. Their front line, their center and wings, or forwards. The defensemen stay in there. And here's another shot. Off the glove, out of play. So a couple of shots on goal here to start this third period. And we're just 1 minute in. West up 5-2. Edgewood has never been on top. They've had a 1-1 tie and a 2-2 tie, and then West went on that trio of goals in an 8-minute period, and just kind of took over the game. Edgewood again. Now, this is another one for Warnke. Leaves it for, I could have saved that one. Leaves it for a teammate. Out in the corner, back out on top. Near side slot. Up back in.
Oof,
by Emmett Rockwell, and another one. Well, Josh knows what the puck feels like now. Start this third period.
Yes.
Face off to his left. Comes around behind the net.
Yeah,
oh, we're
going to
have a penalty. And a tripping call.
Oh.
And this penalty, excuse me, is on West.
To Jacob Evans.
Evans in the box for a couple of minutes. So the power play unit is out there for the Crusaders, and the Warriors, the penalty killing group. And we'll pick up those numbers as we go through. I believe Brandon Thorson, Frank DeBorny are a couple of them. We'll pick up the rest as we go along. Here's a pass near side, red circle, far side board, and sent out. Nice job. By number 17, the defenseman on the other side, Frank DeBorny, the sophomore. He's partnered up in front of us with Max Teckel. And the center in this group, Brandon Thorson, as they try to keep the puck wide, not in front of the net. The Crusaders set it up. And back to neutral zone. Cross-rink pass. Now coming down, aiming for a teammate, and a shot, and a breadbasket save for Warren Key.
Yeah, Jacob saw that one coming all the way, yeah, right into the breadbasket.
Almost a minute gone by already in that penalty. Power play. Each team has a power play goal back in that first period, actually. Oh, nice job on passing by the Crusaders. And they set up. Power play. Ready for a teammate. A little bit different wrinkle here for them. Instead of cross-rink pass to the other defenseman, they leave for the center coming around. And here's a clear out to the goalie. Using up some time. Warriors putting on a little pressure there, but able to get in. Oh, he left it for a teammate. Nobody was there. So it's dumped down quickly by Drew Koharski. Max Teckel off the board in front of the Crusader bench. And we are at full strength now. All teams full strength, so the penalty killing unit for West did the job. And now they are on the attack, and there's a goal.
Wow.
There you are. Sometimes that's all it takes. Penalty was over. They got that extra skater out there. He grabbed the puck and scored a goal.
Yep, it's gonna go to number 11, looks like Josh Moline.
Just a slap shot. The right circle. Would you believe, Spencer, this game was tied at 2 in the second period early?
If I wouldn't have been watching the game, you told me that, I would have told you you're nuts, George.
Because they've scored 4 in a row, 3 in a flurry in the second period, and right after a penalty killing unit did their job, they got another one here in the third period. At 13:04 left. And now on the faceoff, they get, oh, almost had it set up for another chance. Warriors keeping in. And trying to center. Oh, nice pass over near side. Somehow it got over here to DeBorny. And in front, and a slap shot by Mark Sippel, the freshman. Now they control again. Simple. Near side. Whoops, just got by DeBorny. And back out to the slot. Dumped back in by Simple. He's going to come out now. And replaced by Colin Marquardt. Colin Marquardt, number 2. The Warriors, with a 6-2 lead, they can afford to reset. Make a couple line changes. Coming in quickly, Zach Pearson off the bench at the right wing. And skating on the transition for the Crusaders. Slap shot. A couple of defensive sticks got in the way of that shot taken by Jack Royer. Crusaders pivot. Reverse. behind the net. Now they bend it out to the slot. Now they try to dump it across the middle and goes in the near corner. On the front. Whoa, there's it. Whoa. Warnke came out.
Scores.
And they scored.
Wow.
Warnke came out of the net on a rebound.
Yeah.
And I think the player that scored for them did a nice job of waiting for him to make his move, and then he put it in the back of the net. So, scoring, Spencer, last couple.
Well, the only goal for this period is going to West. Number 11, Joshua Lee, that is unassisted.
Okay, and we'll catch the three-setter goal in a moment. That's another unassisted goal. That much I got from PA. Here's a shot, taken slap shot by Jacob Evans. And it's going to be cleared out, and we're going to have icing call here on a 5-on-5 against the Crusaders. So they'll head to our left for a face-off to the left of their goalie, junior Ben Sigalski. Well, Spencer, did you get that last goal for them?
I did. Also unassisted, number 26, Carter Hotman. He's been involved in all three scoring plays for Madison today.
First time I mentioned him, he was in the penalty box. So he's been scoring and handling the puck and in the box, penalties, you name it. All-around player, I guess you'd call him. On the faceoff, neutral zone. Crusaders. Back skating, getting control of the puck, Emmett Ruffley. One of their four seniors. Wes, on the neutral zone. Warriors up with a comfortable lead, 10 minutes left here. They lead 6-3. Over the Crusaders of Madison Edgewood. This is a non-conference game. Finishing up the regular season at home for the Warriors. Nice cross-wing pass. Oops, came off the stick of Josh Boleyn, and he heads to the bench, and we got three new skaters for the Warriors. Two defensemen and center. And they keep it in. You know, that's also a skill and a talent that they practice, Spencer, as well as when they come in. They come in situations where they can make something happen, and that's happened a couple times here today.
Happened just a few minutes ago with Josh Boleyn. Came off the bench unassisted.
Oh.
Wow.
Into the Crusader bench. The Crusader player wants to give the puck to a official, and they're ignoring him. They've got another one. So he was just trying to be a gentleman. All the way around the boards, all the way around to the far side on a pass. Now out in front, missing on the stick, Tharaldson for West. So countering on the transition now, the Crusaders, Drew Lenz, and things end up in the crease. And a little discussion. No, one of the Crusaders is a little bit upset there. I don't think they asked him where they were staying tonight as a team. You know, but this is part of that prep hockey thing, Spencer, this family idea that we're going to go to Wausau, we're going to play, you know, stay overnight, make it a weekend. Oh, bread basket, slap shot by Bryce Kessel to save for Josh Warnke. We've got 9 minutes left from Marathon Park. Hope enjoying our rebroadcast of Wausau West prep hockey. Cable public access 981. And the Warriors, nice job of clearing out. But it's a whistle and an icing. So we'll take a look to our right now for another faceoff. And a couple more players come in for both teams. One coming out for West, Hunter Rickloss. One of their 10 seniors. Faceoff control kept in the zone by the Crusaders. Back to retrieve for the Warriors, Austin Federici, sophomore defenseman. Gets it up ahead. And a shot. And a glove save, yeah. Boy, there's smoke on that one, too.
Yeah, that was a sniper shot.
Josh Boleen. Well, he's got a goal from that spot earlier, so. And he likes that place. Just outside the circle. Where they are now in a faceoff. Number seven for the Crusaders, Cale McCaution. He's 6'4", 210. He's a senior. He dumped it in, but now the Warriors get back and on the attack.
Oh,
offside, yep. Offside. Linesman had that one lined up. It's just a matter of a half a step. But it is offside. And again, the defenseman for West stay in. The forwards and center are in an exchange, and Zach Pearson's in there now, along with Ben Langlois. Ben Langlois Jr., he's at one of the forward positions. And we've got a whistle. West still has control, so we'll wait until they lose it to stop play here because they have the advantage. Comes off a defenseman's leg. They keep it in play. West still has it. Zach Pearson sends it around to the near side. And skating to the net. Evans, rebound. Shot was taken by Kate Lemmer. Another shot, and finally, after a shot by Ben Langlois, the goalie, grabs the puck and the whistle blows, and we have the power play coming up now for the Warriors. Just what they need, up 6-3, power play. But, you know, Spencer, that happens a lot. Edgewood is down 6-3. West is in control. They can play much more under control hockey because they have that big lead. And so where's the frustration going to come from? It's going to come from the team that's behind.
Right.
And, of course, that then in turn adds to the advantage of the Warriors. Power play West. And they've got Pearson in there involved. Now they go on. They set up the power. Oh, nice pass. And a save. He was trying for the five hole, and it wasn't there, so it'll be a save for Siglowski. 6:41 left in the contest, a minute 22 left in the Crusader penalty. Power play unit for West, Max Teckel. Number 21 in the middle, Nick Teckel. Also, Jacob Evans. And now it's sent down. We'll use up some of the clock. Back to retrieve is Nick Teckel for West, along with Jacob Evans. Near side they go. Nick Teckel. Oh, and again, now the goalie Warnke leaves it for a teammate. And we'll have a line change here for West. Coming in quickly, Christian Bartertson and Mark Tech Sipple. Buck is left here to Josh Boleen. Boleen retrieves after he has poked away. Now, coming in front of us, Kellen Tharaldson. That one is poked away. Nice pass. Falling down on the ice, however, losing control. So on the transition, here come the Warriors now. And the puck at center ice. Skating with it, all the way down below the net, Josh Boleen. Here's a shot off a defensive skate. by Kate Lemmer. And Christian Barterton, now it's full strength. Penalty is over. Warriors and Crusaders full strength, West up 6-3 with 5 minutes left in period three from Marathon Park. West in control. Out in front, between the red circles, a beautiful save. Boy, that goalie, that was a slap shot by Christian Barterton between the circles, and that was good reflexes to get that one. Okay, faceoff comes out as Abba's cut short of the PA. Faceoff. You know, they have about 5 seconds of different songs, right, that we're familiar with. Sometimes there are good ones like that one. You know, like to listen to some of them.
Yeah, you don't want them to cut it.
Right now, hockey's more important. Puck right down in front of us. Well, they didn't freeze it yet. They're still working on it. Oh, finally, West clears out. Number 13 came out of there with a John Prokop. Sophomore defenseman. Couple more line changes for the Warriors. The Crusaders of Madison Edgewick coming in with a record of 13-9-1. West coming in 17-3-1, number two in the state, tied in the Valley Conference. Now that regular season is over, with Spash, each with a loss, and they split. In fact, Spash won here, and West won in Stevens Point. A little unusual, but that's what happened. And of the three losses for West, they lost to Spash, they lost to Hudson, and they lost to Eau Claire Memorial. Near side, West in control, cross ring pass in front, in the circles, now it's cleared out. And another whistle. The clock continues to move. Stop now with 3:13 left in this one. West playing some really nice hockey again this afternoon as they get ready for the tournaments. And they expect to go to Madison. They have full expectation to be a part of that state tournament as they are a number one seed along with Spash. And a goal from near the blue line. I think Kellen Tharaldson, number nine. We'll wait and see, but that one snuck through. The goalie didn't see it until it was too late. You don't see that often. You don't see that shot from straight on the net from that kind of distance. But somehow it happened. Face off after the goal. Inside 3 minutes left now. Crusaders back to just got to get it out of their attacking zone. Frank DeVorney, Zach Pearson, and number five, Jacob Cibula. The defense line for West. Colin Marquardt comes out. And let's see who takes his spot. Looks like Jacob Pupp. Junior. Defenseman for West after the faceoff, and it goes out of play. Okay, Spencer, you got it?
We do. Goal is going to go to number nine, Callan Tharaldson, assisted by number five, Jacob Cibula, and number 21, Nick Teckel.
Well, 7-3 Warriors, and after the faceoff, the Crusaders try to put something together, some kind of an attack, but it doesn't happen. Here come the Warriors on the transition now with Zach Pearson. And they get it out in front, goes behind the net, comes to the near side to Frank DeVorney. DeVorney, D to D on a pass. Todd off the stick of the goalie, taken by Sam Sipple. Now the Warriors back skating is coming down the near sideline with it. Number 17, Peyton Smith for the purple-clad Crusaders.
We're going to get a slashing penalty here, I think, George, on number 13 for the Crusaders, Fred Richards.
Well, that's going to be number 17. Peyton Smith is a freshman. We've got some freshmen on their squad. West has three. I think their roster, to be honest with you, I think their roster is varsity, junior varsity together, unlike West. But West has a lot of junior varsity players that play on the varsity, a lot of them, especially with a lot of these games. The numbers they have out. Oh!
Wow! What a rocket!
Christian Bartertson, I think, again. Now, I might be wrong on that one, but I think that was Bartertson, and that came on the inside of the post. Mm-hmm. You know,
yeah.
Game of inches.
Yeah, and a great pass from, I think it was Bartertson that set up number 9, Callan Thurlton.
Okay.
Again, but just a fantastic goal. ABBA again here on the PA system.
They listen to me. Yeah, right. Uh-huh. Okay, the PA is giving you the scoring, and Spencer will have that as soon as they are finished up. Sipple is involved. There's a shot. Goes on into the board off one of the defensive sticks. We're inside a minute 10. Here's a shot. Warnke with a save. That was right on from inside the circles, just outside the crease. But Warnke, you know, he handles himself well in the net. Josh Warnke, 6'1", 170, senior goalie. He did not start this afternoon. Ryan Roth started. And Warnke took over. Down to 40 seconds left. How about that last goal here? Well, I'll tell you what. We've got 40 seconds left. You can do the whole third period.
Sounds good.
Here's a... Oh,
man.
Wide open except for the goalie. I wouldn't call it a breakaway, but it was wide open for Sam Teckel. It just went off the goalie's shoulder. And down in front of us.
The puck was dancing between the defender's skates, and he lost sight of it.
Yeah. A whistle with 6 seconds left. Somebody decided they need a breather, and they're going on the box.
I think they got a hand pass here.
Okay. All right. Yep. No penalty. They'll just come down by Josh Warnke, the West goalie, for a faceoff to his right. Well, on the faceoff, West controls, dumps it down, and they'll just watch it go by, and that's it. From Marathon Park, non-conference prep hockey, our final, Wausau West 8. Madison Edgewood, 3. Spencer, how about that third period scoring?
Third period scoring started with an unassisted goal from number 11, Josh Boleen. Next goal coming from number 9, Kellen Theraldson, assisted by number 5, Jacob Sabula, number 21, Nick Teckel. Final goal of the day coming from power play goal number 9, Kellen Theraldson, assisted by number 19, Christian Bartonson, and number 14. Excuse me, number 4, Mark Sipple. Have a day, Callan Theraldson. He's got 4 goals on the day today.
Well, he had the spot. You can see he loves that spot between the circles. And he just lets it go. 8-3 the final. There were 29 shots on goal for West through period 2. Just 11 for Edgewood, and I'm sure that trend continued in the third period as the Warriors outscored them in each period here tonight, but it was tied at two early in the second period. That's as close the Crusaders came, was to get a tie early in the second period. Other than that, it's been all Wausau West. For Spencer Hart, Dave Dickinson, our camera and producer, I'm George Hirsch. Hope you enjoyed our replay of Wausau West hockey from Marathon Park this afternoon. Till next time, take care.